Both Blackpool and Lincoln City put up comfortable displays in the first legs of in the League One playoffs, which makes them one step closer to making the grand stage. But who's going to come out on top in the second legs and make the final? We'll take a little look. Next! Once again with another prediction of video today, we're taking a look at the old League One playoffs second legs, and we'll get to that in just 1 second. If you're new to the channel, where the heck have you been, boys? Smash your subscribe button, get your banger today with all things League One related, Blackburn Rovers related, whoa, football, we're getting it all here under one rooskies. That's why, boys and girls, yes, Lincoln City and Blackpool in the command as they try to edge closer to making the meet up in the final for, of course, a shot at the championship. We'll talk about that in a minute. Of course, a big shout out to the VIPs. They are the Patriots. Who are they? That's right, the VIPs. Check it out, patreon.com/RoboSeeds. You can join for as little as a cup of coffee. And I'm not talking about the fancy stuff, I'm talking about the cheap shit, all the way up to the fancy stuff if you want to go there. So make sure you check that sucker out, patreon.com/RoboSeeds. But anyway, let's get cracking and have a little look at what took place. But before all that, we're going to go back. We're going to kind of bring you back up to date with the Prediction League in League One. I believe we have a winner. Of course, we'll still keep on continuing with the predictions. Get involved, of course, for the second legs and, of course, the final itself. But we have a bloody winner. So let's get into it and have a look at the recap of those games. These are the games I'm talking about. This was the final day of the season. We did a tremendous live stream. It was fabulous. I did enjoy myself. Even though I was a bit manic, but yeah, it was good. But these are the games we're going to recap first, and then we'll talk about the playoffs itself. So here we go. This is the deal. You can see it. What's happening here? Oh, bloody. Okay, we'll go over these. I'm not going to correct them. So Irish Stringer, well done to you. Of course, Game Show, I did bits. Vincent Long, not too shabby either. Lee Twinton also did good. 47, not too shabby. Jonathan Sandham did okay. Agent 24 also did good. Omaskerville, not too shabby. Well done indeed. Ojo 52 did good. Yenibus also did great. Okay, not too bad either. Sassius Jenko also did very, very good. How about Peter Brafan? He did okay. Chris Welch, not too shabby. Russell Foss also did very, very well. And Yoki Jackson did bits indeed. James Bittesley are great indeed. So everybody did pretty well for the final day of the season. So these are those picks coming at you in leaderboard form, of course. Your kingpin this week was Chris Welch with 7. So fair play to you, of course. Well done indeed. We're giving a round of applause. But we won't look at the leaderboard just yet. We'll now take a look at what's this all about, what we're doing here. We're going to skip all that. That's all nonsense. Of course, this, though, is, of course, the first legs. Now, the first legs did take place already, and I actually went with a 2-2 draw, of course, last time around for Oxford up against Blackpool. But it ended up being a 3-0 win going in favour of Blackpool. Oliver Turton, of course, Elias Sims with a brace, giving Blackpool complete control in that game. And, of course, already probably 1 foot in the final. Of course, they'll bring it back to Bloomfield Road. Fair play to those guys, though. I'm looking forward to potentially seeing them back in the Championship as well. But, of course, they'll have to either say Lincoln or Sunderland. 2-0 win in the end for Lincoln City. Tom Hobb and Brennan Johnson, of course, 2 goals to give them the complete command. Again, completely against what I went on this one. I went the 2-1 win in favour of the Mackhams. Difficult turnaround potentially for Sunderland. It'll make a spicy second leg anyway, regardless of who you support. So let's kick it forward then and take a look at your picks then, shall we? Of course, Cypher did shite. Of course, a lot of people did shite. Shinnon also did shite. It's okay. I think the vast majority did poop. Ojo 52 also did poop. A lot of people back Sunderland, not people back at Oxford. Yannis Leifert did shite, of course. Omaskerville also did shite. Vincent Hong also did shite. At least 51, I'll give you a round of applause for that one. Not too bad either. James BCC also did poop. Mick Harrison, we'll get to you in a minute. SCS, not too bad. Where are we? We're going all over the place. Andrew Watton also did good. Oh, shit. Jakob Jackson, well done indeed. Well done indeed. I'm giving you a round of applause for that because you're a Patreon. That's right. Yeah, Imposter, though. Look at that. Tremendous, tremendous. Gaming Charlie also did very, very poop. AJ24 also did poop. And Andrew Watton also did great. Russell Foss had a shit show there. Of course, Sean Matheson also did poop. And of course, Ultra Mirror, not too bad either. Well done indeed. Well done indeed. So let's take a look at the situation for the Prediction League right here, right now. I do believe we have a winner. Look at all those zeros. I'm in that zero as well. But of course, your kingpin was Yannick Buster. Got both, at least the results right anyway. So fair play to you. But what's that done to the overall table? We'll have a little look at it then, shall we? Do I have a winner? Am I right in thinking we have a winner? We have a winner. Well done indeed, Russell Frost. I think he's won another one elsewhere. And we've had brief discussions about this. But anyway, we'll we'll do a summary of the Prediction League, of course, when we come back around before the Euros. It'll be a master video showcase who won what and by how much. And, of course, hopefully you guys will keep on predicting anyway for the rest of the season and, of course, back into next season, where we're going to spice it up a little bit with, of course, Manager of the Month awards, which prove to be significant. Of course, you'll have your kingpins, your normal stuff like that. But, again, we're revamping it and make it a little bit easier on my end, but, of course, more beneficial for you guys to make it, you know, if you join the back end of the season and then you realise I'm not going to win it, but you could still win it. So it's a little bit spicy in the end. I'll explain it all in the video before we get on to the real deal. So let's kick it off then with, of course, the next round of matches, which of course be Blackpool against Oxford United down at Bloomfield Road, taking place this Friday. So I can't really dick about with this one, get this video out right here, right now. Of course, played for the last nine times, of course, since 2017. It's been four wins apiece and one draw. Of course, the highest win for Oxford was a 2-0 win, so they're going to have to break that record if they're going to get through to the next round. Of course, Blackpool's biggest winner, Oxford, was that 3-0 win just the other day. In total, they've scored 11 goals over those last 10 matches, or 9 matches, should I say, over Oxford. Of course, Oxford picking up 8 goals over those 9 matches as well, which equates to around about 0.89 goals per match. As for Blackpool, 1.22 goals per match over Oxford as well. Of course, managed by Neil Critchley, ex-Liverpool guru there. And of course, Oxford managed by Carl Robinson, forever the bridesmaid, never the bride. And the form rook says Blackpool are 83% in form at the moment, whereas 67% for Oxford. So the chances are it's going to be Blackpool yet again. 65 is your odds for Blackpool for the victory. 94 is your Oxford. And 5-2 is your draw. For me on this one, though, I'm going to go with Oxford to take it. 2-0 win to take the three, not 3 points, but take themselves through to the final with a 5-0 aggregate win and go out in a bit of style. But of course, they can't really take it too easy. If they do, of course, Oxford will open up chances and maybe make it a little bit hairy. An early goal for Oxford could turn it on its head already, but I think Blackpool will be disciplined enough to get through to at least the final, and then we'll see who they'll take on. Speaking of those who they're taking on in the second leg, or the second match, it will be Sunderland up against Lincoln City, of course. Now, these two sides are not familiar that much over the years, of course. A pleasure just 6 times since 2009. 3 wins for Sunderland, 2 wins for Lincoln, of course, 1 draw. Of course, Lincoln managed by Michael Appleton, Sunderland managed by Lee Johnson. Of course, Appleton, former Rover. We don't mind him either, even though he was shit back in the day. Anyway, of course, since 2009, Sunderland picked up 3 wins. Their biggest win over Lincoln was a 4-0 win. As for Lincoln, their biggest win out of the two was a 2-0 win over Sunderland as well. Scoring 10 goals in total over Sunderland in those two matches. Sunderland scoring 14 over Lincoln City in those 6 matches as well. Sunderland with a 2.33 goals per game ratio. As for Lincoln, 1.67 goal per ratio, which of course has changed since the last round. The form book favours Lincoln, of course, 50% form right now, winning 2 of the past 6 games. Sunderland just won once in the past 6 games as well, with a 42% form rate right here, right now. As for the bookies odds on this one, 6-5 is your Sunderland on this one, 5-2 is your draw, and 10-3 is your Lincoln City on this one. Is there anything else we can do on this? Okay, well, let's get to the big screen. I'll give you my scoreline here. 2-1 in favour of Sunderland, which will make a 3-2 win for Lincoln City to go through on aggregate. Of course, that's what I think about this. Make sure you get your picks in, of course, nicely. Now, take a little look at the bookies' odds right here. So 50-1 is your Oxford to get promoted. I'll let you know about that. Sunderland are 6-1. They are outsiders, of course, third favourites to get promoted. Lincoln City are second favourites, 6-4. And, of course, Blackpool 11-10 on for your favourites. Considering they win in the League 2 not too long ago, it's exciting to get them potentially back in the mix once again. But yeah, be sure to get your predictions in for this one. We'll do the finals. We'll cover the final in a bit more detail as well. But of course, yes, be sure to get your picks in. Of course, I know it doesn't really matter for the grand scheme of things. We'll be back next season with, of course, a revamped prediction league where cheaters will never prosper. I'm not saying anybody's cheated in this one. I'm just saying cheaters will never prosper. It'll be via the Google Forms. We'll be trying to improve it over the summer. But of course, make sure you come back for that as well. Also, check out the links down below on Twitter, Twitch, Facebook, and Patreon if you want to support the channel in another way. That's the best place to do it. Also, check out the Discord. It's wide open. Good place to chat amongst others about football, about any concerns, mental health issues, whatever you want to talk about. Get involved in the old Discord. We're there to talk. But until then, I'll see you all soon for the next one, which of course will be the final. And of course, it might be Blackpool. It still might be Sunderland. You just don't know. We'll talk about that anyway later.